A leaking roof, rusted machinery, a factory floor seemingly abandoned after the last shift. A post-apocalyptic nightmare? Quite the contrary.
The thing that everyone came back to was they thought it would be a terrific hotel.
Now that took some vision, but Tom Miller of the development and consulting firm Cavanaugh Advisory Group has been eyeing this property since 2009.
It's very, very expensive to renovate a building like this because of the age and the condition of the building. But we think it's going to be one of the best spots in the city once it's done.
The spot? One of the last buildings to be renovated in the Charlestown Navy Yard. For 70 years, from 1904 to 1974, this was the Chain Forge building, where giant anchor chains for the U.S. Navy were forged and assembled.
This place is unique because they invented die lock chain here at this facility, where you took two pieces of the chain and put them together and welded them, and it allowed them to make long lengths of chain very quickly.
It is a spot significant enough to be listed on the National Register of Historic Places, also designated a National Historic Landmark, and of course, it sits within a national park, all of which makes renovation a bit complicated. Enter Dick Galvin of CV Properties, whose firm has experience in renovation and preservation of historic properties.
The one common element in all of them, they're all important structures, and they all needed the tax credits for the projects to happen. Because pretty much typically building a brand new building like this is cheaper than renovating it because of the complexities.
Complexities like environmental remediation and preservation of 35 of the 162 pieces of equipment for their historical significance. That equipment will then be incorporated into the renovation.
Next door to us is a bay, and that will remain as it is with the trusses and the equipment inside, and it'll become an interpretive exhibit that the Park Service will be able to bring tours through, as well as being the lobby of the hotel. We think it's going to add a lot of activity to the whole street and the whole part of the Charlestown Navy Yard.
Another massive bay will house a restaurant, bar, and second floor function room. Doug Kelleher of Epsilon Associates is a historic preservationist who helped the developers get state and federal tax credits so crucial to making the project financially feasible.
This is an amazing project. I mean, this is very unique. I mean, most of our projects are not of this character, of this significance, so being part of this is a great opportunity for us and for the city of Boston to see such a significant building being preserved.
Tight spaces, heavy equipment, historic artifacts. No easy task for the construction contractor.
The demo and the removal of the equipment and the relocation of the equipment is definitely one of the most challenging aspects of the job. But it's also working in the Charlestown Naval Yard. So there's a lot of elements that go into it outside of the construction that make a project like this challenging.
But when all the challenges are met, this building that once helped anchor the U.S. Navy will be connected, link by link, to both the past and the future of the Charlestown Navy Yard.
This will be, we think, a true destination in the Navy Yard and for Boston for dining, and also bring people to the hotel.
And this will be a big addition because that part of the city doesn't have a lot of hotel space or restaurants.
Right, so much development elsewhere in the city, not much there. They hope to begin construction this fall, open by the end of 2020. And that is Chronicle for tonight. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Anthony Everett.
And I'm Shana Seymour. Have a good one. We'll see you tomorrow night.